completing their nuclear program. You saw that North Korea tested again just days ago their missiles, and so did Iran 2 weeks ago. The Koreans are selling their technology to other countries because they need the money, and the Iranians have promised, Ahmadinejad has vowed to destroy Israel as it's known. Now, Bible prophecy, ladies and gentlemen, is happening before our eyes. Well, anyways, I felt to write a book, and I am amazed at the stir it has caused already. Sean Hannity of Fox read my book already. He is so ecstatic. He said, you tell Benny the second this book is out, he'll be on my show talking about it. Larry King wants it. They're asking for it all over because it deals, this is not, please understand, this is not a book about religion. It's a book about God's plan. But I present the first 12 chapters deal mostly with history, accurate history. If I was not a preacher, I'd be a historian, that's for sure. Because I am very, very mingled in that part of the world. And I will not boast because it's just fact. I grew up with that stuff. My father was involved in politics in Israel. People like Golda Meir, who was prime minister of Israel in those days, used to come to our house. Moshe Dayan, you see Moshe Dayan with a little patch on his eye, used to come for dinner. My mom used to cook for him, for goodness sake. We had officers and generals in our house when we were growing up, and nobody knew why. Today, of course, a lot of that stuff is out about my father, which I won't talk about here. But it's all in my blood. It's in my system. And someone said to me, they said, you are the only preacher from that part of the world that has a big ministry. Don't you think it's time for you to talk about it? I said, all right, I'll do it. As I began writing the book, God, and I mean God, put me in touch with the highest, and I mean highest officials in the Israeli government, including the prime minister himself. Ehud Olmert, former prime minister of Israel, read the book already and said, it's the best I've ever read. He wants to write the foreword. The mayor of Jerusalem just read my book. He said, I've never seen anything like it. He too wants to write the foreword. I have more people wanting to write the foreword right now than any book I've ever written in my life. Because they said, this is needed. They said, the world needs to know what this man is saying about this conflict. Because I go way back to Abraham. I start with Abraham. I take the reader through every main headline of history for that part of the world. I deal with the Roman period, with the Byzantine period, with the Crusaders, the works, right up to the British. I mean, I take you through a journey. It's easy to read. You'll be glued to the book. But I explain why we are in the mess we are in with Iraq, Iran, Afghanistan. It's all tied. Every problem we face today with radical Islam, even the war in Iraq, you can trace it back to the conflict between Israelis and Palestinians. That is the seed of conflict. It's going to lead the war, the final war in Jerusalem. That problem between Palestinians and Israelis is the beginning and the end. You got to understand that, because the last war will be over Jerusalem. Jesus will come back when the whole world is gathered over Jerusalem. Read the scriptures, it's all there. So I talk to a lot of officials, like, you know, people like Eli Carmon. Eli Carmon is the foremost, number one, foremost anti-terrorism expert in the world. The U.S. military reads his books. He trains our military on terrorism. He's become my friend. I sat with him more than once. I've had him on This Is Your Day. I said, Mr. Carmon, what's going on? And he showed me things in his house on his laptop that's happening inside the radical Muslim world. That is, will absolutely, if you should see it, I'm so to tell you, it'll scare the lights out of you. Because you see their plan for taking over the West. But in the book, I do not deal with that yet. But I was standing with one of the officials. I was standing on the border with Gaza. This is just in January. I've been to Israel twice this year. I'm standing on this hill during January when the war was going on. And I'm maybe a mile away from Gaza, no more than a mile. I'm standing with the advisor to the prime minister on terrorism. He came down with me and we're standing looking at what's going on, and I'm thinking, this is madness. Here I am a mile away from death. You see helicopters over our heads. You see tanks in front of us. As we're talking, suddenly out of nowhere, a rocket, Hamas shoots a rocket that landed maybe half a mile away from where I stood. It shook me from head to toes because suddenly the reality of life hits you like that.